Dear student, in this video, I am going to share what strategy we have to follow if the lactone functional group is there. So during the disconnection, which important factors we have to consider? This is the first target molecule. The pattern is same again. What are the different functional groups? So first functional group is carbonyl, second is hydroxy, then one more functional group is carbon oxygen. So carbon oxygen is there and this carbonyl group is there. So identify the relation. So the first relation is a lactone. So lactone ring is there. Another relation is that is a alpha hydroxy carbonyl compound. So there are two relations. Either you have a lactone ring, lactone ring is there, and the second one is a alpha hydroxy carbonyl compound. So on which we have to focus the first of all, always whenever a hetero atom is there, so always first we have to focus on the carbon hetero atom disconnection. Now here there are two possibilities: either we disconnect this bond or we can disconnect this bond. But the best disconnection is always this one. The reason behind is the carbonyl carbon and oxygen, that is the functional group of lactone ring. So because of that, this is always a best disconnection. So this, as we consider, this is the A disconnection and this one is the B disconnection. So B disconnection is always best, and disconnection always in the direction of hetero atom, that is oxygen. So oxygen with negative charge, what you have to do, just you simply write down the hydrogen, look at the analysis. So this side is CO plus. CO plus means the synthetic equivalent is COX. And what is the COX FGI? That is COOH. So that is directly written as OH and COH. Okay, so now what is the functional group over here now? This is a alpha hydroxycarbonyl compound. So this one is alpha hydroxycarbonyl compound. Whenever you have alpha hydroxycarbonyl compound, the hydroxy group acts as a guiding functional group, and this undergoing a, that is which bond we have to disconnect, or 1-2 bond we have to disconnect. So everything that you have to write down on arrow, that the relation is alpha hydroxy carbonyl compound, and which bond disconnect, or again the disconnection of 1-2 bond. So that everything you have to mention it on the arrow, in which direction, in the direction of 2. So that you have to write. So it gives new target molecule. So this is what, this is a alpha carbon and this one is the beta carbon. So this is nothing but a beta hydroxycarbonyl compound or 1,3 dioxygenated pattern. The remaining part is COH minus. So what is the synthetic equivalent for COH minus? Is the CN minus. CN minus is going with the HCN. Now next one is the whatever the beta hydroxycarbonyl compound is there, that is a simple which reaction? Retroaldol condensation reaction. So this which bond we are going to disconnect? So whenever a hydroxy group is there, you start the number from this 1, 2 and 3. So disconnect, which bond we have to disconnect? This forms a double bond here, and we are going to disconnect the 1-2 bond in the direction of 2. That entire you have to write down over here, that you are disconnecting a 1-2 bond. So write down 1-2 bond disconnection and in the direction of again a alpha carbon, that is number 2. So after this, the synthetic equivalent, that is methyl, methyl and dihydrogen and CHO group, and from this side a formaldehyde. So these are the two possible synthetic equivalent. Now the synthesis. This proton is abstracted by the base, that is potassium carbonate, and then it attack on the formaldehyde. So this is what, this is aldol condensation reaction that you write on the write down on the arrow. It is aldol condensation reaction. So it gives what? Beta hydroxycarbonyl compound. After that, you attack the cyanide on the carbonyl group and it gives the hydrocyanin reaction. So having a cyano group. After that, the HCl, what is the role of HCl? Role of HCl is to hydrolyze this cyano group to COH and then COH converted to COCl. It's a good leaving group. And at the end, in presence of acid, the cyclization takes place and it gives the target molecule. Now this is the next target molecule. Again, what are the functional group? You ask to the target molecule, a carbonyl group is there and oxygen is there. And again, the when we consider these two functional group, the best disconnection is always a carbonyl oxygen group that you write down on arrow, that is carbon oxygen disconnection, but in the direction of oxygen. And which carbon we have selected, that this carbon is a carbonyl carbon, that is important. After the disconnection of this, now O minus, so disconnect in the direction of this, so directly it is written, shown as OH, and the other part is CO plus directly, that I have written as a COOH. Now let us find out which relation we have. So this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4 and 5. So it is what? 1,5 dioxygenation pattern. But which relation we discuss under the heading of 1,5 dioxygenation pattern? That is only 1,5 dicarbonyl compound. We have not considered there that is a hydroxy group which is present at 5th position, or you may consider it on what position. Only one relation we have considered, we have discussed under the heading of 1,5 dioxygenation pattern, and that is 1,5 dicarbonyl compound. So what is our first duty? You convert this hydroxy group into a carbonyl group. So follow the path HCI. So OH group, you have to convert it into a carbonyl group. Once you convert it, then it gives the known 1,5 dicarbonyl compound. So from any direction you write down 1,5 numbering, but only what? 1,5 dicarbonyl compounds are synthesized by which reaction? That is retro-Robinson annihilation reaction. So first of all, you have to go with the retro-Michael addition reaction. Retro-1,4 Michael addition reaction. So what is Michael addition reaction? You have to disconnect either 2,3 bond or you disconnect 3,4 bond. So these are the options during this disconnection. But the provided is what? The number 2 carbon and number 4 carbon, they are alpha carbon. So look at this number 2 carbon and this number 4 carbon, which is more substituted. Number 4 is more substituted. Therefore, we have selected 3,4 disconnection in the direction of 4. So disconnect the bond in the direction of 4. After this disconnection, retro-Michael addition, always the Michael acceptor is alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound. So this is what? This is a Michael acceptor and a Michael donor. So this proton is abstracted by the base. So this is a Michael donor. Now look at the synthesis. So this synthesis, what we had to do? This proton, we had to abstract it with the strong base, sodium hydride. Get the carbanion here and then you attack it on diethyl carbonate. So what is the reason behind it? That we have to convert for the Michael reaction. What we need? We need a mild reaction condition. Once you get a carbanion here after abstraction of this proton, so minus, this one is plus, so H minus, abstract this proton and generate a carbanion here. After the generation of carbanion, this carbanion get attack on this and depart the OET group. So because of that, so AR is written over here instead of writing down the ring and OCH2 group. So there is an insertion of COET group. Now, why we do this? Now this proton is highly acidic, so we can use the weak base for Michael addition reaction. So for Michael addition reaction, we need a mild base. So because of that, the activation is needed. So we call this a activation of increase the acidity of proton. So this mild base abstract this proton, get the carbanion and attack on this, that is 1,4 Michael addition reaction. So this is what? This is a 1,4 Michael addition reaction. And one more thing, how we can synthesize Michael acceptor? We can synthesize Michael acceptor by either aldol reaction or by the Mannich reaction. So any one of the route you can follow and complete the synthesis of alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound either by Mannich or by aldol condensation reaction. So acetone plus formaldehyde in presence of base, that is the retro aldol condensation reaction for the Michael acceptor. Now after Michael addition reaction, it gives this product. Now we don't want a carbonyl group, so what we had to do, we had to reduce it with the sodium borohydride. So remember, sodium borohydride reduces only the carbonyl group of ketone and not the carbonyl group of ester. So ester group remain intact and the carbonyl group is reduced, carbonyl of ketone get reduced to OH. What is next? Next is the basic hydrolysis of ester group. So on basic hydrolysis, that it get converted to COH-COH, and then there is a cyclization takes place immediately. So after cyclization, the compound which obtained is this one, and the last part is you don't want this COH group. So that COH group we had to remove by heating, and that undergo decarboxylation. So it removed as carbon dioxide, and that gives the target molecule. Now this is a new target molecule. So again, you can see in the target molecule, there is a carbon-oxygen linking. So automatically, the first way to disconnect the carbon-oxygen in the direction of oxygen. So the same route we had to follow. So it gives OH, and here, COR is written. Now you may have a question, in previous example, we have written OH, now I have written over here OR. What is the reason behind it? The reason behind is at one of the position there is an ester functional group. So instead of OH, now that's why I have written as a ester functional group. What is the next? Now this is what type of functional group you have. This is one number, two number, three number, four number. And so that is one relation. We call it is a gamma hydroxycarbonyl compound. So right, this is alpha, this is beta, and this one is a gamma. So which are the relation? The first relation you can see, it's a gamma hydroxycarbonyl compound. Which is the another relation you can see here? The another relation between this carbonyl group and this carbonyl group. Can you, what is the relation then? This is number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It is 1,6 dicarbonyl compound. So the another relation you have, it is 1,6 dicarbonyl compound. So whenever 1,6 dicarbonyl compound, what we had to do, either you go with the FGI first of all. So due to FGI, this OH is converted to carbonyl group. So after this, look at here, it get converted to carbonyl group after FGI. And if we consider a 1,6 dicarbonyl compound, so 1,6 dicarbonyl compound means just you have to reconnect strategy, that is retro ozonolysis strategy. So it gives this compound. And what is the next? Now this is a retro Diels-Alder reaction. So you go with the retro Diels-Alder reaction after this. So after Diels-Alder reaction, it gives a alpha beta unsaturated ketone plus butadiene. So that you write down here. That is, it gives AR and double bond O and plus this plus butadiene, that is a Diels-Alder reaction. right? This is one way. What is another way? Add activating group. So which activating group we added? Now this is a branch point. Can you see this one is the branch point? So the, at this branch point, the group is added, that is COCH3 group. So activating group is added at the branch point. So because of the addition of activating group, now which relation you can see? Now this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1,5 dicarbonyl compound is there. So 1,5 dicarbonyl compound is there. During the 1,5 dicarbonyl compound, the best disconnection is, now here we have shown A disconnection. So A disconnection is here. After the disconnection of A, it gives this compound. Now look at here. B disconnection, look at B disconnection. This is number 1, number 2, number 3, and number 4. So B disconnection is what? 1,4 dicarbonyl compound. So during 1,4 dicarbonyl compound, the best disconnection is always a 2,3 in the direction of more substituted alpha carbon. So in the direction of more substituted alpha carbon means B, which is more substituted alpha carbon. So this one is the more substituted alpha carbon. So we have to disconnect the bond in the direction of this. So the remaining part is COMeCH2 plus sign, plus sign. So we have to write over here is electron, the leaving group, that is a Br. And the remaining part is this. Now here it is 1,5 dicarbonyl compound. So 1,5 dicarbonyl compound, you number it. And after numbering, again, we can disconnect this bond because it is more substituted. So after this disconnection, 1,5 dicarbonyl, it gives what? After the 1,5 dicarbonyl, it gives this compound and then plus remaining part is a double bond, COCH3, that is Michael acceptor, vinyl ester, COOCH3. Next one is, it is nothing but a 1,3 dicarbonyl compound. Whenever you have a 1,3 dicarbonyl compound, the simple, you disconnect the bond in the direction of alpha carbon. So this is nothing but a ARCO. OCH3 is the leaving group here. And again, C is MeCOOCH3. So that is simply a ester condensation reaction. Now here, so we remain with this part. After 1,5 dicarbonyl compound, it gives this compound, and then again a 1,3 dicarbonyl compound. These are the situation. So among this, so how many possible routes we have? Among these complicated different types of routes, now which route we have to follow during the synthesis? So look at the synthesis. During the synthesis, that this is number 1, number 2, that is, which ester is this? It's a it is dimethyl succinate, right? So the reaction of this sodium hydride, sodium hydride, it abstracts this proton. So this proton is abstracted by the base. And then it attack on this. The carbanion is generated here and attack on this, and methoxy group is removed. So it gives this compound. After that, there is a, again, this proton is abstracted. That is a Michael addition reaction. This is a Michael addition reaction. This proton is abstracted by the base and then it attack on the 1,4 addition. So Michael addition reaction, it gives this compound. After that, there is a hydrolysis. Due to hydrolysis, all ester groups are converted to COOH group. And then there is a decarboxylation. Due to decarboxylation, whatever the group we have added, that group is removed due to decarboxylation. So after this, there is a heating. And again, the COH group, we had to convert it to an ester functional group. So again, reaction with methanol in presence of H+. So only the thing is what, due to hydrolysis and heating, whatever the COME group is here, that group is removed. At the end, there is a reduction H2 palladium carbon in presence of acetic acid. The reduction of this carbonyl group. After the reduction of this carbonyl group, then it undergoes cyclization in presence of acidic media. After the cyclization, it gives the lactone 3. Now, this is the new target molecule. Now, which are the functional group here? The first functional group you can see is the carbonyl group. The another functional group is again AC means which group? AC means it is a CO and CH3 group. So CO, CH3 group, that means which bond we had to disconnect? We had to disconnect this bond. So the base disconnection is the disconnect a bond between the AC and oxygen in the direction of oxygen. So it gives what? OH here plus the remaining AC, that is acetyl chloride. AC plus, that is acetyl cation, means acetyl chloride. Now, what is the functional group here? It's a primary hydroxy group. Whenever a primary hydroxy group is there, you simply go with the retro reduction reaction. That means you have to write down the carbonyl group there. So retro reduction reaction. So instead of hydroxy group, you write down the FGI, that is ester functional group. So whenever a simple carbonyl group is there, so next to that is a alpha carbon. The best disconnection is always next to the alpha carbon, but in the direction of alpha bond. So what is the remaining part? That is double bond CH2 plus double bond CH2 plus, that is it gives this compound, while the remaining is COAT CH2 CH3 group. So this proton has to be highly acidic. What is important for this? This proton has to be flanked by two carbonyl group. So need to add the control. So you remember here, whenever you have such type of reaction, then you always prefer add control. So what is this? It is a diethyl malonate. You start with diethyl malonate. You treat it with sodium epoxide in presence of ethanol. So this proton is abstracted by the base. And then getting a carbanion, after formation of carbanion, you attack the carbanion on this group and depart the leaving group, that is I minus. So there is an insertion of methyl group. After this, again, one more proton is there, which is highly acidic. So sodium ethoxide abstract this proton and then it attack on this and depart the leaving group. So at the end, it gives this compound. Now, you don't want this ester functional group, so hydrolyze it, and after hydrolysis, you decarboxylate it, so do the heating. So because of the decarboxylation, one of the group is replaced and another group is converted to COH, and that COH, again, we have to convert it into an ester, so it gives COET group. Now, at the end, you don't want ester functional group. So you go with the reduction of ester group by using a lithium aluminium hydride. It converts to CH2OH. And at the last, we have to convert it into an ester functional group. So treat it with the acetic anhydride in presence of base, that gives the target molecule. So you refer the book for this, Designing of Organic Synthesis by Stuart Warren.